This is the Navigator, a Raspberry Pi computer-based flight controller for underwater robotics, surface robotics, and drones. It's fully featured, ArduPilot compatible, and has an open source schematic design. Hi everyone, I'm Rusty here at Blue Robotics. We're excited to announce the Navigator flight controller today. It's been in the works for a long time. With it, we're also announcing BlueOS, our new core operating software that unifies access to tools and features you need for your robotic vehicle and provides a foundation for some features yet to come. For years, we've been running our BlueROV2 with the Pixhawk Autopilot and Raspberry Pi computer. On the Pixhawk runs the ArduSub ROV control software, which is a branch of the larger ArduPilot project that we created and have managed since 2016. The Raspberry Pi computer, meanwhile, manages communication and video streaming through our open source companion software. The Navigator flight controller replaces the Pixhawk with modern, capable, consolidated hardware. It's a board that plugs into the Raspberry Pi computer's expansion port and transforms it into a fully featured flight controller. It's focused on marine robotics applications like the BlueROV2, but not limited to just that. You can also use it to control drones, ground robots, or anything that moves, really. On the BlueROV2, the Navigator still runs the ArduSub software, but now it does so directly on the Raspberry Pi in Linux rather than on a microcontroller. This brings everything into one place, creating a cohesive user experience and developer experience. Let's take a look at the Navigator, starting with the onboard sensors. It has a 6 degree of freedom IMU that provides three-dimensional angle and rate measurements, along with dual magnetometers for robust compass heading. It has a barometer to measure air pressure, which can be used in above water applications to measure altitude. It also has a built-in leak sensor circuit and ports for our SOS leak sensor probes for underwater applications. And it has a 16-bit analog to digital converter to measure battery voltage and current from a PowerSense module and from two user accessible analog inputs. In the center is an array of expansion ports that tie into the Raspberry Pi 4's extensive peripheral support. There are four serial ports and two I2C ports available on JSTGH connectors with pinouts that follow the Pixhawk connector standard and Blue Robotics connector standard. The Navigator comes with expansion cables compatible with these ports to help you get started quickly, and it's compatible with a number of off-the-shelf GPS units and sonars like the Ping 360. At the back of the Navigator are 16 digital outputs that can be used as PWM channels to interface with speed controllers, servos, lights, grippers, etc., or as simple digital outputs to drive relays and other devices. For drones and surface robotics applications, there's also an RC input to connect to remote control radio receivers. There are status LEDs along the side of the board, including an RGB LED, and a port to connect to an external NeoPixel compatible LED. The Navigator is designed specifically for the Raspberry Pi 4 computer. It comes with a custom-designed aluminum heatsink that fits between the Navigator and Raspberry Pi and allows the Raspberry Pi to operate at high CPU usage in poorly cooled environments like inside an enclosure. The Navigator board plugs into the Raspberry Pi's expansion header. A slot in the Navigator board allows the Raspberry Pi's CSI connector to be used for the Raspberry Pi camera. The Navigator is manufactured here in the United States with a high degree of quality control and consistency. The schematic design of the Navigator is open source and available for you to refer to if you want to write your own software or expand beyond its basic usage. Along with the hardware, we've put a lot of effort into our new core software, BlueOS, to make the Navigator easy to use. BlueOS replaces the companion software on the ROV and is a collection of tools and features unified through a clean, browser-accessible user interface that makes using the Navigator a great experience for users and for developers who wish to build capabilities on top of it. BlueOS, which is built on top of Raspbian Linux, manages the computer hardware and the services and features that run on it, including network configuration, autopilot software, software updates, communication, camera and video streaming, and user-defined extensions. There's a lot more that will come in the future of BlueOS, but this is where we're at for now. The Navigator is available today and will soon come installed on every BlueROV2 vehicle. Check out the product page for a lot more information about the Navigator and about BlueOS. We welcome collaboration on the open source software, and we'd love to answer questions about how you can use the Navigator and BlueOS in your application. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. See you next time.